Rajesh Sivpala, Product Line Marketing for Libra Software. And in today's training, we initially discuss about the software licensing updates, like what are the old options we have, license options we have, and what are the new options that we implemented, and what is the difference between them. Then we will largely focus on the use case examples. Finally, we will go through the FAQs. So, old split-off devices for reference. I am referring to the license options available before 13th March 2017. In old free gold license, we supported Smart Fusion 2 and Igloo 2 devices up to 060K density. So we supported Smart Fusion, Igloo, Pro ASIC 3 and Fusion families. And we also supported a few other Antifuse and RT families. These options are still valid if the customers are using Libero SoC version 11.7 SP3 or older versions. But the free gold licenses move to a paid license. Okay, so existing license options. These license options introduced with Libero SoC version 11.8 release on 13th March 2017. Earlier, we have only one free license option, which was gold, and now we are providing two free license options called evaluation and silver license. The free evaluation is a 60-day license and it supports all the FPGA families available on Libero SoC version 11.8 and later releases, and it also supports all the families with Libero SoC Polar Fire software. This license supports all the features of Libero SoC but does not support programming and debug features. On the other hand, we have free silver license which supports PolarFire 100K LE devices, Smart Fusion 2 and Igloo 2 devices up to 25K LE non-security devices. And it also supports Pro ASIC 3, Igloo, Fusion and Smart Fusion devices. This silver license supports programming and debug features. We have two paid license options. We basically moved the free gold license to a paid gold license and added support for PolarFire 100K LE, 200K LE devices and 300K LE kit based devices. We also added support for all Smart Fusion 2 and Igloo 2 devices including 090 and 150 devices. We are also supporting all the security devices with gold license. With this license, we are also supporting mixed language simulation. By supporting all these features, we are offering this gold license for a very less price, which is $995. On the other side, we have a platinum license which supports all the families and the features. The customers who purchase kits will get a free suitable license. So you might think that it will impact the customers, but there is no impact on the customers who are already using their current licenses until it expires. On expiry, if the customer is using devices less than 25K LE, then they need to migrate their designs to Libero version 11.8 and use a free silver license. If the customer is not interested to migrate to version 11.8, then they need to purchase a gold license. The new silver license is equivalent to old gold license, but we moved the G4, that means Smart Fusion 2 and Igloo 2 O50 and O60 devices to paid gold license and added PolarFire 100K LE device support. Libro IDE customers need to pay for gold or platinum license upon expiration of the existing license. So here are the available software license types that are offering by Microsemi. As mentioned before, evaluation and silver licenses are free licenses. Eval supports for 60 days, silver supports for 1 year. And the evaluation supports mixed language simulation, but it does not support programming and debug. On the other hand, silver supports single language simulation. It supports programming and debug features for a limited FPGA and SoC devices. So, in existing licenses, the free evaluation license supports all the devices that are supported in the Libro SoC software. And the silver license supports 100K LE of PolarFire, and it supports up to 25K LE non-security devices of Smart Fusion 2 and Igloo 2, and it supports Smart Fusion, Fusion, Igloo and Pro SP3 families. So the difference between old gold and the new gold is it supports PolarFire up to 200K LE devices and 300K kit based devices of PolarFire, supports all the devices of Smart Fusion 2 and Igloo 2 including security devices. Rest all are same. We created a few use cases on Libro license options and the software ID clarifications. How to identify the license types from license file? So there is a feature line in the first line of the license file. So here if you see actl_vista, then it is a gold license. If the feature line is actl_summit, then it is a platinum license. If it is actl_eval_soc, then it is evaluation license. If it is actl_base_soc, then it is a silver license. How to identify the node locked license? So the disk ID node lock license will be locked to a specific machine or PC. You can identify the node lock license by verifying the host ID information. If the host ID is equal to a disk serial number, then it is a disk ID node lock license. And this disk ID is a 8 character hexadecimal number, and the valid characters are A to F and 0 to 9. How to identify a USB dongle license? The USB dongle license allows users more flexibility to move or transfer the license between the machines easily. Similar to the node lock license, you can identify the USB dongle license by verifying the host ID information. If the host ID is equal to a flux ID, then it is a USB dongle license. The flux ID is a 8-digit number and it begins with 9-. How to identify a floating license? Floating license is a server-based license. This license will be locked to a server machine which allows multiple users to access the server, but only one user can work with the software at a time if the number of seats in the license file is 1. In the license file, if you have the server and daemon's information, then it is a floating license. And this floating license is a 12-digit MAC ID number. So based on the previous use cases, I have created a small example to identify the name of the license file by seeing the license file. So if this is the license file, first we need to check the feature line. So the feature line is actl_vista, which means it is gold, and the host ID is equal to a flux ID, which means it is a USB dongle. By seeing these two information, we can easily see that this is a Libro Gold USB dongle license. how to identify the software ID types from the license file. License has a unique software ID. So this software ID information will be available at the last line of the license file. So if you see this license file, the software ID is highlighted in yellow color. So if any customers want to renew the license, they need to provide the software ID. So how to identify the license path? So if customer says that I have a license located on some location and I am unable to find the license path, then we can ask customer to open the Libro and go to the help menu and ask them to choose the license details. In this license details, you will find the license path of the license location. So when to use incremental license? Incremental floating license allows user to increase the number of seats for the existing floating license. The price for this license is calculated on a pro-rated basis. For example, if a customer purchased a floating license for a single seat today at $3,000, after 6 months, if they want to increase the number of seats by one, then at that time they need to pay only $1,500 because 6 months are already over. Here are the examples on how to place a purchase order based on the customer requirement of a floating license. So if a user would like to order two brand new platinum floating licenses with one seat each, then in the purchase order, we need to provide two line items. Each line item should contain a part number of a platinum license with quantity as one. Then the customer will get two licenses with two unique software IDs with one seat each. On the other hand, if customer want to purchase a new platinum license with three seats as a new purchase order, then in the purchase order, we need to have a single line item with the platinum license, floating license part number with quantity as three. So restrictions of Libro Platinum or Gold floating licenses. I would like to inform you that there are few restrictions with Synopsys and Mentor tools integrated in Libro Platinum or Gold floating license. Synopsys tools will not work on geographic locations or it will not work beyond 50 miles distance. Please refer the KB article here to know more details on this Synopsys limitation. On the other hand, Mentor tools will not work beyond 800 meters. This information is already available in the EULA agreement, software EULA agreement. So please refer that software EULA agreement for more details. So if the customer uses the standalone microsemi license, then these restrictions is not applicable for them. So restrictions of Libro Platinum or Gold USB dongle license. There is a restriction on USB dongle license. The USB license will work with Libro IDE 8.4 and later releases. It supports all Libro SoC and Libro SoC PolarFire versions. So if any of your IDE customers ask for USB dongle license and if they say that I am using Libro IDE version 8.2 or so, please ask them to buy a floating license or disk ID node lock license. So finally, we have the FAQs. So based on the previous slides, we created these frequently asked questions. So references on licensing. So customer would like to install a software, then they can use the software installation and licensing guide, and if they have any issues while installing, they can refer the troubleshooting guide. If they have any questions on the installation or the licensing, then they can refer the FAQ document and they can refer the software agreement. I would like to highlight the Libro license selector guide. So basically, we created this license selector guide which will guide users to select the required license based on the target FPGA device, Libero version, operating system, license types like disk ID or USB dongle or floating license, etc. So this guide also provides the details on the information required while placing the purchase order, and it also has the pricing information. So please refer this license selector guide